Hi, and welcome to our sixth video about our DevSecOps pipeline, which we are building with GitHub. In this video, we will have a look at how to scan container images. In our past five videos, we have built up the following DevSecOps pipeline with GitHub. In the first videos, we just looked at GitHub and at our sample project and how to build this project. Then we had a look at how to scan for vulnerabilities in dependencies. This was the software composition analysis. Then we checked in all of our libraries which we are using if the licenses which we are using are compliant. And in our last video, we did a static application security test where we found all of the vulnerabilities in our code. In this video now, we want to see if there are any vulnerabilities in our Docker containers. Hey Padi, how do we scan for vulnerabilities in Docker containers?
Let's take a look. As mentioned, container image scanning is all about finding vulnerabilities in the Docker image. By default, this includes both operating system components as well as your own application provided libraries. This also means that most likely container image scanning will find also things that were already found by the SCA step. If you do not like that, you may configure it out. We, however, will stick to the basics and keep it as it is in default. And this is where we add this new step of container image scanning. After build, we add a build Docker step and a container image scan step. To make this happen, I will extend the main pipeline with two sub-pipelines or sub-jobs. One job is to create the Docker image and store it in the registry. The other job pulls the image from the registry and scans it for vulnerabilities. And at the very end, this second job also pushes vulnerabilities into the GitHub security tab and makes them available for download as a zip file. So I start the IDE again with the dot. And navigate to the correct file. We start with the main pipeline that we extend with the two sub-jobs or sub-workflows. Our Docker job needs the build job as a prerequisite. That build job creates the running application. The Docker job will be available in docker.yaml, which we'll create afterwards. The Docker job also outputs an image tag name. This image tag name is added as an input to the second job. The second job being the container image scanning job that receives the image tag here. Obviously, this means that the scan job needs the Docker job to run first. The container image scan job will also be defined in its own file. Now let me create the first file. To stick to our naming scheme, we do all the jobs start with a D. so that GitHub lists them nicely at the very end of the list. So we have here the build Docker image job. It can be started manually, or it can be started by another workflow. The workflow in this case is our main pipeline or our main workflow. This time we also define an output. So this job here will output an image tag. The value of the image tag comes from a job we defined below in this file. We also need a Docker registry and the image name we would like to create. Now here starts the definition of our Docker job. We define here an output for this job, this time image tag, which gets its value from a step we define below. And this actually is the value we provide to the calling workflow. As always, in the steps part, we check out the files, this time for the Docker file that we need to build the Docker image. And we download the pre-built application binary, so our application. The application is then used to build the Docker image. Then we log into the container registry by the provided data from GitHub. And we extract some metadata from Docker that can be used in the build and publish step afterwards. The build and publish step creates the Docker image file and pushes it to the repository. The name under which it publishes the repository we provide in the with part. This is the tags we received in the extract metadata step, and this is also the tags that we use in the exported part at the very start of the module. Now that we created the Docker image, let's create the steps and jobs for the container scanning. For this, I again add the file we defined in the main pipeline. As always, we provide a name so that the order in the GitHub user interface is nice. Then we define how this sub-workflow or action is called. First of all, it can be started manually, but it requires that you add the image tag that you actually want to scan. Then it can be called from other pipelines, in our case, from the main pipeline. And as we saw in the definition of the main pipeline, it receives the image tag from the main pipeline, and that's the image that was created in the previous action. We also define the registry settings and our job name. The steps of this action is we log in to the container registry using the definitions we made above. We use Docker pull to pull the container image we created before, and we run the container image scanner, in this case it's Trivy, an open source product, on the pulled container. One of the most important settings in this section is the output, which should be serif so that GitHub understands the format. And in the last step, we upload the scan results so that the GitHub security tab can show them. Now let's commit everything. and head back to the project. Let's see what our pipeline did. It's well visible that build Docker image worked and container scan is here part of build Docker image because they are dependent on each other, as visible here. The scanner was also successful in finding vulnerabilities. I'll go to the security tab and head to code scanning. Here I select in the tools section Trivy. If we look at the findings, we see that many of the findings are within app.jar. This is the application we built. So these are dependencies of us that now have vulnerabilities in. And most of these findings were already found by the SCA scanner. But we also have other findings. This one, for example, is an error in an SSL library. I'll go back to the overview.
Hey, Paddy. The container scanning has now increased the security vulnerability findings by 100 new findings. And you just said, and you also pointed out, that some of the findings are duplicates to the other findings which we already had. So how do we deal with that many findings?
Well, the right thing to do here is obviously to try to fix them. Fixing in this case means basically updating our libraries within our project. This will then remove vulnerabilities from the Trivy scanner, so what we did right now, and it will remove the findings from the SCA we introduced in a previous session. If you do not like that they are duplicates, you can also exclude app.jar from the Trivy analysis, for example. In general, if you find some vulnerabilities, then you have to decide how to kind of resolve them. And the default action should always be, let's update the libraries and make sure we get rid of that stuff. If updating is not possible, then work starts. Then you need to investigate, do these vulnerabilities have an actual impact on my application? If you find that they have an impact, then you need to assess the risks they have. If the risk is considerable, meaning high, you will have to figure out whether there is a workaround to kind of reduce the risk, or whether you even have to shut down the application and stop. As said again, default action should be remediate everything and resolve the findings. In a later video session, we will show you how you can manage vulnerabilities within GitHub.
And with that, we are at the end of this video. We just saw how we can implement container scanning within GitHub. For that, we first created our Docker image, and then we scanned the Docker image by using the open source library Trivy. And with that, we are at the end of this video. In our next video, we will have a look at secret scanning.